Why, hello there, and welcome to our wonderful worst list. Before we start the festivities, I'm gonna plug the Patreon. $2 gets you into Discord, and $5 gets you early access. So if you like the channel and you want to support, click the link below.
Oh boy, are you ready for another worst list?
He don't like me, but his bitch love me.
Sure, why not take some time to talk shit about all the shit that the kids are listening to these days? It's not like we don't have a bunch of other problems in the world that can actually affect us, but if you're one of those older folks who clicked on this video, expecting me to laugh at Auto-Tune and Justin Bieber and all that rap stuff, well, I hate to break it to you, but Auto-Tune hasn't been a thing for over a decade, Justin Bieber is no longer relevant, and rap is not crap. You're just a dumbass. Also, not all modern music is trash. I just put out a video proving that. You should absolutely go watch it if you haven't already. But that doesn't mean we don't still have crap right now. Just like we had crap in, let's be honest, all generations. But hey, let it never be said that I'm not an equal opportunity hater. I have been doing these worst of current year lists for 5 years now, so what's another one? Let's take a look at... Oh boy, this again. Yeah, everybody, it's Luke Bryan again, doing his Luke Bryan thing with the stuff, and... do I have to?
My mama loved her, her daddy loved me.
Well, we have a Luke Bryan song about how boy loves girl. Lyrics are about childhood sweethearts turned long-distance relationship, which is something, I guess.
But after that first fall, got longer between the calls and
still has that voice of his. Sounds like, well, all of his other songs. I'm sorry. Who in 2024 is clamoring for more Luke Bryan?
Better the devil you know than the devil you don't.
Like, have you heard country music lately? It's changing, evolving right before our ears. They're adding more rock elements. They're being more introspective with the lyrics. Hell, they're even being more diverse for once.
Girl, I'll see you when I'm dreaming.
And meanwhile, here's white bread Luke Bryan putting out the same slop he's been putting out for the past three centuries. Nothing's changed. He could have released this in 2011 and it wouldn't have made a difference. I don't like him. I won't miss him when he's gone. And I mean it. Probably. So this next one is only on the list for two reasons. One, because I wanted to have something from the global chart. And two, because I needed one more to bring the total up to 10.
I just killed a man, she's my alibi.
Maybe it's just me trying to be less of a negative Nancy, but yet again, filling out this worst list was pretty hard because there just wasn't much crap. I know there are some of you who like it when I point and laugh at modern music because it's all trash and shit and blah blah blah, but I actually do listen to it, and no. It's not all trash. Hell, I don't even think this is trash either. It's dumb, though.
I mean, I do kind of like that chill beat. I'm not familiar with this Adam Port guy, but hey, he made a beat that's as chill as they come. On the other hand, he also made this with DJ Assault.
Should we leave the club?
So that's one strike against him already. Jesus fuck, you want a dumb song? Look that one up.
And the guy singing isn't too bad, I guess. He sounds... fine. Just fine. So, what could possibly be so dumb about this? Well, there's this one line. I want to get naughty, yeah. That's just, wow. You want to get naughty, eh? Very naughty, right? Girl, I really like the way you ooh. And the rest of it is... Okay, maybe dumb isn't the right word. It's more mindless. He just likes the way she moves because she's so sexy she reminds him of sex. If anything, I feel this could have had more substance. Like, there's three or four artists on this track, but does it really sound like it needed that many? I hate to sound like one of those crusty old boomers sharing that meme of old songs having a few writers and new songs having many, blah, blah, blah. But like, this could have easily been done by just one person. We don't need five or six. Maybe I should just declare myself the manager of whatever collective this is. First order of business. Everybody, fire the person to their left. Thomas Red is not a bad artist. I don't think he's, like, a hack or anything. He's made a few good songs. Crash and Burn, I thought that was pretty good. Look what God gave her, how perfect he made her. But he's made his fair share of crap, like Look What God Gave Her, and this. What's someone as beautiful as you? Here we go again, another country song about how, girl, you're so beautiful and he loves you, girl. Wait, is this even a country song? Like, it has a piano and stuff, but it doesn't sound very country. This belongs more on the adult contemporary station than it does on the country station. Still a mystery, what's someone as beautiful as you? Dare I say it, the closest this comes to being country is that it sounds like a lame Bruce Hornsby in the Range song. And when you've got me calling Bruce fucking Hornsby lame, you have definitely done something wrong. You're the type people wishing they sit next to on a flight. Wow, that's one way to put it. Oh yeah. I wouldn't give to sit next to her on a flight. Oh, she has a baby? Never mind. The day we met, you could have just ignored me. Here I am, laying next to you, looking extra cute. And so he's like, what's a beautiful girl like you doing with average old me? You know, the lyrics are pretty much all about her looks, nothing about her personality. I should stop asking questions for you, get a bandy. Yeah, you probably should stop asking questions. And I should probably stop talking about this because there's nothing else. Before you get a belly.
I love you, Reba.
Welcome back, Pitbull. And I see you brought back Neo, so you can finally make Give Me Everything too. Be still, my beating taste buds. Part of me wants to drink, take me to the bar. Actually, Neo's hook is alright. I like how he's like, part of me wants to stay at home, part of me wants to get turned. Let's party all night, darling, but let's not kid ourselves. We know we're here to see Pitbull performing his greatest hits. So, let's run through the checklist. My DNA is MIA, I'm a grown man. 305, check. Mr. Worldwide. Mr. Worldwide, check. Whoa, check. Reporting live from a solar eclipse. Reporting live? Oh, that's a check. Reporting live from Cape Canaveral. See, this is something I don't think anyone's pointed out about Pitbull. He's always reporting live. Reporting live from the tallest building in Tokyo. Like this one, he's reporting live from the tallest building in Tokyo. And here, he's reporting live from a solar eclipse. Me, performing Thank God and Jimmy Buffett, that's me, with John Bon Jovi. Yeah. With the late Jimmy Buffett and the not yet late John Bon Jovi. Oh yeah, pretending to hang out with famous people, that is a check all over the place. And there you have it, this does indeed have everything you can ask for in a Pitbull song. He might have gone away, but he never really went away. Reporting live from my cheap-ass armchair, this has been The Same Old Shit.
Another one for the record books.
I know sleep is friends with death, but maybe. You ever have that one song you didn't really mind at first, and then when you heard it a fourth or fifth time, you were like, wait, I just realized something. This sucks!
You and me belong together.
Yeah, that was this song for me. First time I heard it, it was fine. I like the ukulele. It's nice and happy and fun and stuff. But then I noticed that this song, unfortunately, has other things.
Damn it, it's so good to be alive.
Like, this kid sounds a lot like Shawn Mendes in places. And we barely need the actual Mendes anymore to begin with.
Belong together. The time.
And the lyrics are about how, well, we belong together.
Like cold ice tea and warm weather.
Yeah, together, like iced tea and warm weather. Or, I don't know, like dead skunk and dog shit. And, yeah, this is just lame. The kind of lame you would be hearing on the quad of a college campus somewhere, with a bunch of other students gathered around waiting for him to finally play Wonderwall. College. I left that clown world years ago. I'm not going back.
I'm Chris, and I approve this message. Recently, this country has been hit by a lot of hurricanes. And thousands are looking for answers. Well, here, I have an answer. Hurricanes are formed in tropical climates over the ocean. They begin as tropical waves, and over time they suck the heat from the waters to form a cyclone. Meanwhile, in the clouds, water condenses and forms droplets, releasing more heat to power the hurricanes. From there, they continue to move until they reach land, which breaks the momentum. The further north they go, the weaker they get, which is why they usually tend to wreak havoc on the southern states. In layman's terms, no, Biden doesn't control the weather, you stupid fucking bimbo. The Contemporary Hit Radio Criticism Club is responsible for the content of this advertisement.
So, here's a song you folks my age and above might remember. Drift Away by Dobie Gray, the one that goes, rock and roll and drift away. Yeah, you know the one. Did you ever want to hear it reworked as a sleazy country song? No? Well, somebody did. And that's how we got here. Hi, Dustin Lynch. Haven't dealt with you in a while. I see you're still sporting that douchey cowboy hat. And I see you're still very much a douche.
She was dressed to kill, I was in my booth.
Anyway, here's round three of I Thought We Were Supposed to Be Past This. Country boy sees a pretty girl and wants to pick her up. So, you know, they talk for a while and...
She said, give me a dirt road, the window's down.
Yep, there it is. The girl is using the song as a pickup line.
She said, give me a six pack, some Brooks and Dunn.
I mean, yeah, it's still a guy singing, but hey, give him credit for having the girl in the story use the pickup line.
Oh, I forgot to mention something.
so I had to pick for the uptown time.
See, he thought she was a city girl. But guess what?
If you want a country girl, you just found one.
Yep, she's a country girl, so she gets to have his penis in the back of a Chevrolet. Let's see, is there anything else I'm missing here?
We were at the door before the end of the song.
Oh yeah, Joey Roll is on this. Not sure why. He doesn't really add any perspective, he just picks up where Dustin left off. But hey, he's there!
What you waiting on? Just give me dirt, roll the windows.
And he's joining forces with Dustin Douche to ruin a timeless classic. And I think there was some girl on this too? Yeah, that barely audible female backup voice belongs to Canadian singer-songwriter Madeline Merlin.
You want a country girl, you just found one.
And she does not appear to be credited on this. I think they just threw her part in to be nice guys. Probably jacked off to it too. In the Chevrolet. Oh, we're not done ruining the 70s yet.
Baby, come back. You can blame it all on me.
That's right. Time to have all your memories of that classic chestnut, Baby Come Back, completely tainted. Oh, and guess who's back?
Screaming, baby, I'm back.
Yeah, baby, the Kid Laroi is indeed back. Now, he does have a few other songs I could have picked.
Sorry for myself.
Like, this one sucks.
Girls just wanna have fun.
And this one really sucks. Honestly, they both suck worse than the one I went with. But the reason I picked this is because I honestly thought this was gonna be good at first.
Started off as an attraction, now it's turned into attachment.
I mean, I don't outright hate the Kid. He has done some good songs, I swear. And this is him reflecting on the past 12 months of his life, and it's
been a crazy last year, I'm trying to process still.
Kinda deep, by his standards at least. The sample sounds pretty good too. But then he sang along with it and
to the way it used to be, just so I feel what I've been missing.
You tried, Kid. I'll give you this, you tried.
I swear, okay, baby, I'm back.
I mean, he really did turn this into Baby Come Back, but it's Baby I'm Back. You know what this brings to mind? When it's karaoke night, and you pick a song, but instead of following the lyrics, you just make up your own. Because you're like, so creative and talented, that you just have to show all the other bar patrons.
You could have it all, you see, but
yeah, no, this is making me want to listen to the original instead. But hey, at least he had the decency to play the actual song at the beginning, and at the end. That counts for something.
If you see her at tonight, she'll be flirting with Jay. Yeah, and I'm the only one to blame.
So around the beginning of the year, there was this song called Wine Into Whiskey that showed up on my radar. And, well, what can I say? It really hit me.
I took a good thing.
This sad, regretful song about a man coming to terms with how badly his drinking has not only fucked him up, but his partner as well, it's definitely one of those songs that always puts a tear in my beer. The reason I didn't have it on the best list is because, well, he sounds like, that. Yeah, that voice is almost nails on a chalkboard level irritating, but It was only one bad thing. I could live with that. And then Tucker Wetmore got this other song that started charting around the same time. I never really paid much attention to it, but it's still hanging around in the bottom half. So I figured I'd give it a listen, and...
Saying everything out of the moon to get you into my arms tonight.
Well, he still sounds like that. It's pretty irritating. I'd put it around here on the scale for the record. And for another... It's crap.
You look like waves on a sunset.
Like, what the hell happened here? This is just a stupid lovey-dovey slop song.
You look like wine in a truck bed.
Where he lists a bunch of things that his girl is like. And if she doesn't have sex with him tonight...
Here's a fist and I don't turn into two. You look like I'm gonna wind up missing you.
Dude, I think you got a pronoun wrong. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to say, I look like I'm gonna wind up missing you.
You look like you love me.
Oh, and real quick, this brings me to another thing I've started noticing in country music that's becoming like a pet peeve for me. You look like you love me. You look like I need a drink right now. Or here, I got a better one. You look like I fucked your mom.
The kind of boy your daddy never wanted you to go and fall in love with.
Oh, and he's also a bad boy. Yeah, the rebel that her daddy warned her about. But he swears he's gonna be good this time. She's probably never heard of that before.
You look like I'm done looking.
Yeah, he's done being his old self. He assures you he's learned from his past. And after he turns her wine into whiskey for the 9th time, he's definitely gonna wind up missing her. Or at the very least, look like it. I'm just gonna say it. Some people should not appear on rap songs. And no, I'm not saying this because of the incident. We really gotta try and let this one go, internet. No, I'm saying it because of how out of place he sounds on a song like this. It didn't work on Broadway Girls. It didn't work on Broadway Girls, but it's locked away. So, hey, why not try to make it work with a different rapper?
Okay. Feel to the top again. Feel back now, back in it.
Well, Moneybagg Yo has a pretty good flow, and he's rapping about drinking, and now he's trying to stop, but he can't. Seems fine, right?
Can't get tired of it. I'm on you bad.
Whiskey, won't you go away?
Then Morgan Wallen comes in, and it's just ruined. His honky-tonk warbling never goes well with trap beats, especially not on his own stuff, and it goes even less with this one. And then his verse is just... Oh lord, he's trying to pull off a rap flow and it just comes off as whack. There's a reason he works better on a Post Malone song than on this.
She was sitting, now she gone again.
Bless his heart, Moneybagg Yo is trying his best with his ad-libs, but nah. Listen, Morgan, I know you love hip-hop. It's nice that you're trying, but it's never gonna work. Don't feel too bad. It didn't work for Justin Bieber either.
I'm tired of it, tired of it.
And now, you know the drill.
Let you cut me open just to watch.
Look, I want to give this new singer a chance and all, but... I don't know. She's a Scientologist, and you know how loony they are.
But you got no confidence.
Boo, play Million Dollar Baby again. Oh great, another one of these dumb clout-chasing rap songs named after a famous singer. This is just getting stupid now. Like, ASAP Rocky has a song called Taylor Swift. Oh, sorry, Taylor Swift. Wake me up when someone makes one of these songs called Meghan Trainor. That would be good for a laugh at least.
I think what you really need is whoops.
Speaking of which, there she is, still hanging around the pop airplay charts because she just has no place else to go. And this ain't too bad. I kinda like how snarky it is.
Whoops, you messed up. Turn around and then you got caught.
Whoops, you got caught cheating. And here comes Joey Greco in his soul patch. You're really fucked now.
Some codeine as a way of coping.
Well, I said I was gonna have a talk with society if this was still around. So here it is. Do better, society. That's it, that's the talk. Also, Toby should have been a hit.
How you get it off the nigga you hating on numbers untouchable? They got the data wrong, this is the moment.
The musical equivalent of Drake declaring, I won this election by a lot! This is no baby shark, but it's always good to have something for the little kitties, I guess. And remember Barney? To be honest, I always thought he was a little overhated.
Tell me who.
This isn't terrible. It's got a nice beat to it, but Chris Brown still sucks, so it's here by default, I guess.
Oh, say does that star spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free?
Kids, don't drink and sing the national anthem at a baseball game. I really hope she's doing all right in rehab. And on that sour note... Remember that Chevrolet song from earlier? Well, we already know it's not the only song from this year to ruin a timeless classic. And guess what? It's not even the only country song to do so either. Like, there's a country song that lifts the riff from Rebel Rebel and turns it into...
Good girls that can't keep from falling.
This fucking horse shit. Now that was on the chart the previous week. It has since dropped out, but I have a feeling I'm gonna be dealing with it the next time around. But you know what hasn't dropped out? The other time Jelly Roll helped to ruin a timeless classic.
Lonely road, take me home.
And out of all the songs I just showed you, I think this might be the worst. For one thing, it starts with a jump scare. I'm pretty sure you know this song, right?
Country road.
Yeah, the one that goes, country roads, lonely. West Virginia! Yeah, that's the one MGK and Jelly Roll are gonna ruin for you tonight.
Lonely road, I'ma go downtown, ain't been in a long time.
Actually, let's back up a bit. Are they really ruining that song? Well, I will give it this. Taking country roads and making it more introspective is a very creative move.
Where'd you go now?
It's one of those ideas that could work if done right. And the two artists were surprisingly pretty good ones, especially when you know that they used to hate each other. This could work. This could be good. And yet...
I probably could have saved us, but instead I let us crash.
Something about it just doesn't sound right. I don't know. I always thought any version of Country Roads would have sounded weird with percussion. Snapping in MGK's verse is minimal enough to work, at least. But then we get to Jelly Roll's verse.
The face I knew, and I probably could have saved us, but...
Trap beats. Really? Now this reminds me less of Country Roads, and more of Morgan Wallen's stupid attempts to fuse trap and country. You can stop trying this experiment, by the way, Nashville. Those two things are never gonna go together. On a chart where we suddenly got a bunch of rehashes all at once, this is the worst of them all. Not because of what it is, but because of what it should have been. Take out the trap beats, lower the speed a little bit, and I probably would have liked it. But as it is, nah. This lonely road needs more construction.
Baby, can you help me? Mm. Baby, can you help me? I'm trying to get my life together, leave these hoes alone. Pray to God I can leave the street, this thing and shit get more than old.